In my last video I made on this, I got a lot of feedback saying that I was going a little too fast. So I'm going to try to go a little more easily, keep it as sophisticated as possible, and go step by step. And hopefully this video will be more helpful. So first and foremost, you want to go into settings, click on security and privacy, make sure that you have apps from unknown sources enabled, this one right here, allow installation of applications that aren't from the App Store. And so it says allowed on here, and if it doesn't say allowed, just click on that. It's for the Silk browser specifically. I don't think you should use Chrome or anything else. Silk browser would be the best. This is basically the Safari of the Amazon tablets. So anyways, it says allow from this source, and mine is enabled. If yours is not enabled, it'll be in gray just like this. So just press it once, and you're ready to go. Now you can click the home button on the bottom and go into the Silk browser, which should be on top here. And then I do have the website linked down below in the description and the comment section, or you can read it off from here. It's a how-to geek article on how to install the Google Play Store. So I want to give them credit for this because they did a good job in laying stuff out if you want to read through this. But the main thing is they do have the download links down here, and there are four things that we have to download. So I'm going to go all the way down here, and when you see this yellow type of note and then there's like a yellow bar above, that's the first thing you want to download. So Google Account Manager is first, Google Services Framework. Oh, and I think it froze up on me. There's a lot of ads on this website. Just like that, it just reloaded on me, the whole website, because there were just too many ads. But anyways, going back to it, up here, it's that there's four things to download. So I'm going to scroll all the way back up just so that we're clear. So Google Account Manager is the first one. Then secondly, it's Google Services Framework. Third is Google Play Services. And then fourth, you go all the way down until you see Google Play Store. So these are the four things you have to download. And for this one, the Google Play Store, it's really straightforward. There's only one download, all models. I'm actually going to go on the download link too, just to show you that how it is, because it could be a little deceiving. There are some ads that have the download button, but those are not the download buttons. And by the way, if it asks for any information like signing in or your name, get off of it. You're way too far. You probably clicked on an ad by accident or something popped up that shouldn't be there, because this is totally free. You don't have to do anything. You don't have to give out any of your information. All right, so going back to it, I have the Fire 11. It's the latest version, and you can tell which generation or version you have on the left side here, or you can actually go into settings and take a look at that, but I have the latest one, so I'm going to click on the latest one on here. Or wait, whoops, it says down here is the latest version, technically speaking. So you can either click this one if that's the right one for you, because I do have the latest version. 11th gen was the last gen, and then this is the latest one for Google Account Manager for 12th gen. I technically have the 13th generation, and look at that. This just popped up out of nowhere. I wasn't looking up the Lenovo Tab M10 at all. Just popped up, I guess, because I was trying to click on this, but then it accidentally clicked down there. So I'm going to try this again. I actually have the 13th gen, so this should still work and be fine, because it is the latest version. So you see here, this is what the first download looks like. And you see where it says start or activate now. Both of these are ads where you can read advertisement on there. So we're going to skip those and go all the way down till we see like this Google puzzle thing. So you're usually going to want to click on the one that's on the top here, the first one, unless if it says beta. If it says beta, then ignore that and just use the second one. But in this case, there's no beta, so we're just going to click the download icon here. That's in gray. So clicked on that, and then it says add on top, so we're going to click the X button. Let's see. Okay, and now it takes us to the download page. Sometimes it might automatically start, but other times it will not. So just go down, and let's see here. See all available downloads. All right, and then it says no DPI. So we're going to want to click on this one right here. Click download or the download icon. It should be Right here. So I know it's a little confusing. You have to go through like three different areas just to download this. And finally, we're here though. It says download APK in red. They're all going to be in red except for the last one, which we'll look at. So download APK, and you should finally be able to download. Are you kidding me? It should be starting on its own. Yep, there you have it. And then you'd click the download button, and it should save in your downloads. So I'm not going to download this because I already have it downloaded. So I'll click cancel for the time being. But you click download. And then you can go back, close this once it's downloaded, go back into the How to Geek article. Right, back to the second thing, which is Google Services Framework. So I'm going to download, it says don't use a version newer than V10. Interesting. Okay, so this is the latest one. Just click on that. And sometimes it might be frozen, unfortunately, because I guess these tablets are only so fast, and the other thing is there's too many ads on here. When you click view in a simplified page that pops up, I think that's probably the best way to do it because it's a lot more clean and it's going to be faster. And then now this is the second one here, so just going to click on that download icon here, scroll down, click on that, and it should be hopefully starting soon. Oh no, I got to click this too. So we're on step two. Click on the download APK. That's in red. And then finally, we have this popping up. So you're going to click download. I'm going to click cancel because I already have it downloaded. And then I'll go back to the How to Geek article again. Now, on to the third one, Google Play Services. And I clicked on this one here for the 12th gen. Oh, it just went up a bit. And yeah, that can be a little confusing. I think the page is kind of loading things up. So that might get a little confusing. You might have to scroll down or up again or just reload the page too. I know it's a lot more complex than it should be. And it is a little annoying to the point where I feel like I should make my own website and just have something up here so that you won't see as many ads or anything. But that's I digress. Now I'm here, Google Play Services, and now this one could be a little tricky here because the first two you see it says apps related to Google Play Services. Ignore that and just go all the way down, and we'll download the first one here for the version 23.39.57. It may change depending on when you watch this video, and that's totally fine. I'm just going to click on this one here to download. And let's see, you're going to have to go all the way down, click, see if it, or you don't have to click on it, but I'm just going to click on this one here. Click on that download icon. And then hopefully, I think there's one more button we have to press. Go down. And then it says here, download APK bundle. Huh, interesting. This is the first time I'm seeing the Wear OS on here, but I'm just going to download this one for Google Play Services Android TV. Okay, see, oh my gosh, we have to go through so many hoops. It's kind of crazy. Actually, let me go back a second. I might have missed it. I apologize. I apologize. That was not the right one to click on. I was a little confused at that, but again, that's a little confusing. So I'm going to go, I scrolled all the way down on this one, clicked on Google Play Services. And I guess this is a bundle, so we'll have to download this however. I think you may have to download the Android OS. Yeah, this is just what it is, I guess. But I'll just download the latest one here. Click on that download icon, and I don't know what this is. I don't know why they changed things up here. I guess they made it a little more complex than it needs to be. So just bear with me here, guys. So let's see here. Gonna click on this download icon. Okay, finally. And finally here, can click download APK. And don't tell me there's one more page to click download. That's gonna be the worst. Okay, finally we're here. So it says, do you want to download this anyway? I'd click download anyway. I'm gonna click cancel here just because I already have everything downloaded that I need to. Okay, now going back to it. Going back to the How to Geek article. Now the final one is the Google Play Store. Now this one's going to be a little more easy because there's only one link here for the Google Play Store, and it looks like it froze on me. Now the only difference with this download is that The download button is going to be in blue. So I'm going to click the latest one here. I don't see any where it says beta, so I'm going to click down. I'm going to download the latest one here, the one on top. And then I'm going to scroll down a little. And I'm going to click download APK. All right, and then click download anyway. Oh, I should not have downloaded that because I already have two of these. So let me just go ahead and cancel that. Now all of them should be downloaded. And so when they're downloaded, you're going to want to go into the home button, click the home button, go into files. And then in files, you're going to click the download area or button. And if you don't see the page looking like this, if it looks more like this, that means you can just filter it out using the button up here. I don't know why my camera is like having some trouble, but yeah, click on this icon and it'll change the filter here so that you'll see it like this. And the reason why you have to kind of see the name is because we have to download this in order. And in the How to Geek article, it shows that you're going to be downloading this starting at the last name, which says GSF login. Then the second one is GSF. The third one is GMS. And then the fourth one is vending. So as you're downloading these, so if I download GSF login, which is the last one on here, oh, don't want to check that. I want to download it, install it. You click continue and then click install. And then once it's done installing, just click done. Do not open it up. Then the next one is GSF, which is this one. You can click continue. You can click install. I'm going to click cancel because I already have it installed. It's going to mess something up. And then once that one's done, just click done. The same thing with GMS. Just click continue. Click install. I'm going to click cancel again. And then finally, and then click done. Don't open anything. Then finally, vending. And then once this is downloaded, install that too. Once all these are downloaded, you're going to want to, you may see the Google Play Store, I can't even talk today. You may see it down here. Don't open it just yet. You're going to want to hold the power button and just restart the tablet. Now, once it's restarted, you're just going to go down. You can now click the Play Store and it should open up just like so. You may have to sign in. And now you're good to go. But if you do have any problems, I do have a separate video for this where I address some of these issues where it doesn't open up or it opens up and then closes after a few seconds or immediately. So I will have that video and annotation here or there. And I hope you guys enjoyed this video and subscribe for more. As always, thanks for watching.